What is up, y'all lovely people? Can we talk about irritation? I'm irritated about a lot of things, and I'm gonna get through them all before we start spectating this next match, because obviously we got it just finished, and maybe not. Irritation. So number one, I am seeing every single day like a new story regarding deal, like sales or bundles that are, you know, priced less than if you got the items individually for the Xbox One and for the PlayStation 4, all over the goddamn place. Everywhere. Cannot get away from them. For the Wii U, though? Nothing. Fucking radio silence. It's the exact same price as it's always been. Nothing there. It's pissing me off, man. Irritation. Number two, you can't... Why... Are there any games in general? Actually, I think I might want to... Okay, this connection looks solid. Are there any games on PlayStation 4 that natively allow you... No, I know there are, because I know I've done it before. But so, like, this game, you can't just look at the player list. Let me actually check this out real quick. Okay, so this isn't... Oh, there we go, member information. So I can't come in here. You see all the little microphone things there? I can't scroll through that and look at them and say, like, please mute this person, anything like that. There's nothing available in the actual lobby itself to allow me to mute microphones. I just have to hold that. Shoutouts to Rachel. Of course, the dirty-ass Rachel player is going to be the lag abuser. Of course. Of course. I'm judgmental as shit. Nice cat chair? But yeah, so it's like... The lobby I joined before this one was actually more lively and seemed more entertaining. But like, five of the people in there were all talking on microphones. And for some reason... In regard to the capture, anybody talking on a microphone overpowers the game sound, basically, and I have to turn the game sound down, or otherwise they may even overpower me, just depending. And obviously that is terrible, and we don't want that to happen. Yo, Tarumi running it back? If he does the little, not that, I mean, that might, is that not throw invo? Oh, that's right, it has armor. It has an armor point. It's not actually invulnerable. That makes sense. Get bodied, lag abuser! Oh, God. But yeah, so, like, because there's no good way for me to be able to disable microphone audio... Like, I think you can if you go all the way back to the PSN menu and you look at, like, your friends list, and in the one of the menus in there is, like... recently played or something like that. I know that's what it was called on Xbox. I don't know if that's what it's called on PlayStation. And then you go in there and you can find all the list of names and you can just individually mute them. But the problem is that, like, that permanently mutes them. And I'm not going to remember that I muted these people, right? Like, next time I run into them, and who knows, maybe they're trying... I mean, highly unlikely they would be trying to communicate specifically with me, but let's just pretend they are for a second. They would be muted, they'd have no idea, I'd have no idea, because there isn't a way to just say, for this session, please disable microphone audio. I have to go and, like, disable the players individually, which essentially winds up being permanent. What the fuck? This is how you know that the players are playing in a shitty connection when you see gameplay like this. Wow, and now we get to suffer through another round of this. Because the Tarumi just keeps dashing and doing nothing else. It's a wonderful life. But so I know I mentioned that next time I played, I would tweet that I was playing. I'd open up my own lobby. But right now, it's too late. Like, I can't sleep. I fell asleep for like 30 minutes. About halfway through the day, and for some reason, if I ever fall asleep at any point in time during the day, like, I'm just fucked from then on. Like, I'm not gonna be able to fall asleep at my normal time. I am going to be wide awake for far longer than usual. Like, I don't know what it is exactly, but I do not require much sleep. And so because of that, if I do get, you know, like, just a little bit of sleep that I wasn't planning on, I wind up being awake for a lot longer than usual. God, this dude in his purple throws. I mean, granted, there's really nothing else. It's like, it's not worth trying to play normally in a bad connection either, because it's not going to work. It's just going to be an aggravation to try and do it. Oh, nope, never mind. I think he tried to purple throw there, actually. He's going to get purple throwed. Nope. I think they tried, but I don't actually know what Rachel's air throw animation is. I actually, because I originally wanted to just, I wanted to come over here and play, and just sit in training mode a little, because that's one thing I haven't, like, I've done Hakumen's challenge mode, I've played through, like, arcade mode and score attack mode with him just to kind of try and get used to pressing buttons in neutral and things like that, and, just to try to get used to him, to try to get acclimated to him, but then I kind of realized, like, I don't really have real hit confirms yet. I mean, yes, I have that stuff from challenge mode, but most of those combos are not... I think his corner combos are good. The corner combos he has are good, but most of his mid-screen options just don't really properly teach you what to do. And so I really need to work on confirming mid-screen stuff. And especially things like... Shit. I saw one player who was landing the 623A, A follow-up, which is like the launcher punch thing, with 5C on certain characters, but it doesn't, it's character specific, so like that's something that I would want to learn and want to ensure, oh god. So I have one request. If you ever play me, and you ever know it's me, I mean I'd hope you know just for how often I bitch about it, I'm okay with skipping the stage introduction. I'm okay with that part. But at least let the character introduction play out. At least until it's ensured that the connection is smooth and everything is looking copacetic, everything looks wonderful, and it's running nicely. Don't just mash on the button to get to the match as fast as possible, because part of Arc System Works netcode is that it smooths shit out during that introductory period. And if you don't allow it to, you're gonna have a worse connection than you would have otherwise. So please... If you ever felt anything for me, if you ever loved me at all, you super villain scene-skipping motherfucker, please, let the shit play. I've been watching too much Flash. It's really funny to me. I mean, like, it's... The Flash is a really good show. I actually think it's the best... I'd have to think about it a little bit, but I think it's the best superhero TV show that I have watched personally. I mean, there's not a whole lot. Like, I've watched Arrow, I've watched The Flash, I've watched the Netflix stuff, but I haven't really watched, like, I don't watch Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Was it just Agent Carter, where they had, you know, like, that Peggy Carter chick from the first Captain America? She got her own show for a little bit. I don't even know if that's still on, but I didn't watch that either. So I think those are the only show. Oh, and yeah, oh, I just said the Netflix stuff. But yeah, so out of those, The Flash is definitely the one that I would consider the best overall. But it really amuses me how it's like 10% of the fights that he has against supervillains come down to, here's this scientific solution we found to this specific character's superpower. Just make it happen and you'll win. And then the other 90% is like, Barry, you're super, super fast, but you doubt yourself. All you have to do is believe in yourself, Barry. Because Barry, I do. I believe in you, Barry. You can do this. And then he does it. It's just like, oh, so that's just, you know, he just needs to believe in himself harder. That's all. It just really amuses me how almost every single fight comes down to that, for whatever reason. Oh, please, God, no. That's even worse. Legitimately, nobody plays characters I actually like anymore. Where did they all go? Everybody just left, and the only people that are left are Murakumo unit users, Hazumas and Terumis. I've actually seen a fairly hefty chunk of Amanes, which surprises the shit out of me, because when I left, nobody played Amane. Noelle? Who likes Noelle? Nobody likes Noelle. Nobody should like Noelle after Continuum Shift. Jesus. But it's just kind of amusing. Like, I haven't seen a single Valkenheim. No Talkaka. No Bang. No Hawk. Well, I've seen a couple Hawkmans. The only Tager I've seen is the European dude I played that I've already... I'm terrible with names. I'm sorry. But... no Azrael. Who else? I didn't see one bullet, but he was... So I actually kind of wanted to talk about this for a little bit, and I might as well, because I think this... Who's the one? The... Mune Akira, however the fuck you pronounce that shit? I think they just have a terrible connection, because it looks... Every single person they played, it looked terrible against. And they didn't even use wind to bring him down to confirm? Like, son... So where was I going? Right. I think too many people in this day and age, in the world of combo videos and like... I mean, really, that's just kind of it, right? Like, most... The greatest extent a lot of fighting games go to quote-unquote, teach you their game, is to give you a challenge mode where you just go through a trial of like... What the fuck? Of like 10 combos and... Oh my god, the drive spam. I'm back in, like, 2010, 2011? I don't fucking know. I haven't seen this in ages. But yeah, so, like, they don't really teach you how to play neutral. They don't really teach you how to try and defend against stuff. And so, like, there are a ton of really good players, but... They have no defense, they have no neutral, they have hit confirms and combos and that's it. And so like you watch them play, and when they get a hit, they go nuts, they go bonkers, they look amazing. But the moment they're put on the defensive, everything goes to shit. And so the reason why I'm mentioning, like, yo, this player, they know, like, with how smoothly they keep doing that, they know the world they live in. They know what their connection is and how to utilize it to maximum effectiveness. But yeah, so, like, this player, this bullet player, really on point with the hit confirms, really had good setups, good mix-ups, had, you know, some pretty dirty resets, but no defense whatsoever. Like, all they did was just hold down back and hope that at some point offense ended. And for a lot of characters in anime games, offense doesn't end. It just keeps going. And you have to be active in order to get out of it, whether or not it's to just hit an A button to try and check them out of what you know is an unsafe setup, or you have to escape somehow. Like, you can jump away from whatever they're trying to do. You can backdash. I mean, you know, any number of those options, but there was no active defense. There was no real... attempt to avoid mix-up or anything. They were just hoping that it would just be a block string that would eventually end and then they would get to play. And that's not how a lot of games work. And it was the same thing. I watched this player. His name was Oka, I think. Japanese Hakumen player. And the reason why I watched him is because his was the first video that popped up in regard to Central Fiction Hakumen when I was looking up what his changes were to kind of compare them to what I had learned. And... it was the same thing. Like, his offense on point, meter management, pretty damn good. There were some flaws he used. He used the super counter far more often than he probably should have. But that's kind of the big thing that my big problem with him in general is, like, his hit confirms were on point. His mix-up, his offense, on point. But he had no defense. He hit counter a lot. He kind of like panic countered. It wasn't a guaranteed thing. He didn't really block very well. Never really tried to escape from things. And like, you know, you kind of see that and it's like, that's going to hold you back. You can't just, you can't go into training mode and only focus on your offense and expect for that to be enough. You have to practice defense. You have to practice neutral. And if you want to be a great player, then you have to have all of those. And... so yeah, like, just, I think right now too many people focus too hard on basically trying to be combo videos themselves and just toss everything else out the door. What am I watching? Nice burst! Oh, good God, help. Help. I mean, at least pick the stylish, but like, if you don't even know how to do a two-hit combo with your character, Just pick the stylish mode version at least. Oh boy. See, like, shouldn't that lead to like 5K? I think every single counter hit this dude has gotten has been with a C button, which all of them should lead to like 5K minimum. Alrighty then. You know, I'm gonna go. I forgot to get a drink before this. I'm gonna just go do that. Y'all enjoy this shit. Tell you, man, I'm gonna be in trouble tomorrow. I just realized how late it was. Like, I basically have to be at work in 4 hours. I don't even know if I'm gonna fall asleep then. I'm gonna be tired. I'm gonna be very tired. What does he say? He definitely doesn't say Kagura. I don't even know why I picked Asriel's system voice. I don't even know what he says half the time. He doesn't even say people's names a lot of the time. Like, the clearest one he says is Ragna. I mean, obviously you get that one. If you ever see him, hear him say Ragna, he's just like, Ragna the Blood Edgy! Oh, okay. That was very emphatic. Shit! This connection is booty butt cheeks. I'm gonna beat him solely with this combo. Never mind, no, I'm not. Jesus. Did I join the wrong lobby? It said 3 bars. Granted, that's only the host. I didn't even combo. Holy shit. Help. Okay. God damn it. This is all so surprising! Why would you do that? I didn't mean to do that! Jesus Christ. Waited all that time. Waited 18 minutes. For that match. Shit. Part of me wants to play Hakumen, but like, I know my Hakumen sucks, and I know it's not at a level yet where like I can actually do anything real. And so I kind of want to just stick to Tager and Asriel right now and just kind of get back into the swing of Blaze Blue more so than trying to learn new shit. But I should be sitting in training mode with Hakumen at least a little bit in order to... I clearly joined the wrong lobby. But yeah, I should... spend some time in training mode, work on Hakumen, at least get hit confirms, and then I can work on neutral in real matches. Oh, that's right. That's mad safe. I forgot how safe that was. Shit. Nailed it. That was all the setup. Would have killed him off of that. God damn it. That didn't anti-air in time? Shit. Why? You started that off of 5A. That's not worth it. I don't know why I tried that. I was just hoping he might like run up 5D or something. Okay. Got you. What? Huh? Alright. Nailed it. It's probably really bad how often I just try to late tech button press against people, like against anybody that really has their shit nailed down, that's got their shit on lockdown, their setups. That will never work. But I do it so often against people until like I know that it won't work anymore. I mean, that was only the second time I tried it. The first time he just sat there and hit 2A over and over. And then the second time it fucking worked. Oh, you can't back out of this? Shit. I was going to pick Tager instead, but apparently you cannot back out. Once you have gotten there, I would have thought they would at least let you to allow you to back out until you picked your color. But apparently not. Okay, this is looking a lot better. Until they ran through it. Oh dear. We'll see. What? What is happening right now? What is this person doing? I was supposed to be Growler. What? Oh, shit. I don't know what's happening right now. Right, that's an overhead. I should have known. What is this offense, though? Like, 7A presses into, like, something. That is mad safe. What is this offense? I'm so baffled. I can't believe that actually hit me. What the fuck? What is happening? I'm just gonna fucking do it. Fuck it all. I hate my life. This is bullshit. God damn it. I missed like 3 fucking Rekkas in that entire match. God damn. And that wasn't lag at all. That was just bad timing on my part. Shit. is everybody playing Tarumi? You guys have Susanoo soon. Fuck this guy, man. They didn't even really make him worthwhile either. I mean, did they? I don't even know what they changed for. I know they gave him a standing overhead, which everybody was like, yes, it's gonna change the world! But you need meter to actually confirm it. So, like, whatever. That's kind of irrelevant. I mean, it's more relevant to him than anybody else who requires meter in order to hit confirm there. I mean, isn't Jen really the only other... I'm trying to think of anybody else that can't hit confirm their own standing overhead. But I think, like, Jen's the only one that really comes to mind, because I believe Valkenhayn got a new one, too. But I think he can wolf cancel it and get a confirm off of that. That was strange. What? 6D? That activated fast. Should have rapid canceled that. Oh, my bad. I was not paying any attention whatsoever. Why did that hit me? That's a command grab. I cannot remember how to fight this character. I can't remember what's safe, what isn't. I'm just getting hit by random shit. That up. I don't think that even works off of that. Surprising how many people only block high against Azreal. I think it would be better. I'll do one more match. Hopefully I'll lose. I'll pick Tager. Let's end it on a Tager fight. But yeah, I think doing 2A, 5A Rekkas. Or maybe even just 2A, 2B. But either one of those instead of... Because I do like 2A, 5A, 5B, 5B. Which is just a fucking awful idea. It's an atrocious idea. Because in the corner, I can't get a weak point off of it. Like, I can't use a weak point, nor can I get one at the tail end of the combo. And so because of that, I should really hit confirm that better. Or even just like... Maybe just 2A, 5A, 5B, 2C into 6D. And then either I get the weak point or I do a jump combo after that. Because I think it's the Rekkas that kind of murder the proration and disallow me from using a jump combo afterwards. But yeah, I need to figure something out instead of doing what I'm doing right now, because it doesn't work. It's not optimal. What? Oh god. Help. Help. I'm in the Rachel loop. This connection's a little... There's a little bit of input lag to it. I notice it. Oops. I didn't think that was gonna hit.
What? Why would you do that?
Because it beat me. They knew. Damn, I tried to armor it for some reason. Like, 6A's armor is worthwhile in that manner. You ever feel bad? I kind of feel bad. How do I get to, like... That's not what I wanted. Be polite! Run away. But yeah, so like... I mean, I need to spend time. Oh, can I bitch about something else? Some other irritant that I didn't mention at the very beginning? For those of you that are still here, you get a special edition of irritation. None of my colors, literally zero of my main colors, exist in Central Fiction. Jordal posted a video that he scrolled through all of the colors that every character has in Central Fiction, barring... colors, I think 23 and 24, which are like Japanese magazine subscription specific. Like, you have to have a subscription to those magazines in order to get them. But so he scrolled through all of the colors. So obviously I'm looking at the characters I am looking to play. I looked at Bullets, I looked at Azriels, I looked at Daggers, I looked at Hakumens. And so Azriel, obviously my main color with him is 8. Like, that's almost the only color I picked. There are other ones. Like, I don't think anything below, yeah, I don't pick any of these. But, like, I like this one. I do not believe that one is there anymore either. Like, not that one's not... I picked that one instead of the pink one I picked now, but that one's not there either. I think both of these are still there. I think that color is still there. Sorry, at first I thought that was his Guilty Gear colors. I'm just looking at it and I was like, that kind of really reminds me of Johnny? But his Guilty Gear color is Slayer. But anyway, yeah. So, I think he still has that color. Everybody still has that. I think it's a little different. Wow, that actually, because of how it blends in with his cape in the background, it actually looks like there's just pieces of his body missing, which I never noticed before, and I actually kind of really like that. Like, that's probably going to be the color I'm going to wind up picking, because I don't think... any of the other colors that I usually pick with him, none of those are there. Bullet, that's my main color with her. That's not there anymore. I think, though, there is... It's not that one. I think it might be that one, I think, that I saw that I'd probably start using now. Or it might have been that one. Probably that one. But yeah, none of the other colors really... I actually kind of universally like color 20, if I'm being perfectly honest. But I don't think that's in the game anymore. Tager doesn't really matter to me, because with Tager, like... they got rid of the color that I used for Tager back in Continuum Shift, and it has not returned. This is the closest thing to it, except I don't think he has even this color anymore, which is saddening. But, I mean, I basically just used the Potemkin color now. Everybody has retained their Guilty Gear color, so I'll still have that. But yeah, like, they kind of... And then the color that I settled on for Hakumen is color number 7. I actually really like this color for him, and that is no longer there. Granted, again, everybody still has their Guilty Gear colors, and I really, that's probably my second favorite one. Then they also, I think this one got kept, and I like this one for him as well. But anyway, yeah, so, I really need to, yeah, did you hear that? He's so intense! But I really need to figure out who the hell I can, do that against. So obviously Ragna is not, maybe is it possible to, like... But then what do I do after that? I think you can after that. I think you can instant air dash into a oh wow, you have to actually wait a little bit of time in between. Yeah, you can't just, like, do it. Oh, okay. I'm just trying to kind of mash it to see, like, how soon I can... Okay. Let's see. Let's see if I can't do this. Oops. I suck it. I'm just gonna do it from this side just for ease of use. Oops. It would help if I actually did it. Shit. Why can I not jump? It's a basic thing. You hold up. Holy shit. Maybe not. I thought that was how you confirm, but maybe you need to confirm it higher than that. So what do I do? Maybe I just do like fucking... just do that, I guess? There's gotta be something better than that. Oh wait, maybe I hit a normal first and then I do it. Like, can I do... nah. Because I'm kind of thinking, with how low he is off of that, I mean, kind of just simulate it with that. That doesn't really give me time, but depending on where exactly he is in the air... or do I just do... like, do I just do that, maybe? Oops. But it looks like that will work? Oops. But surely there's gotta be, I mean, I'm using 3 meters anyway, there's gotta be better hit confirm than that. So that does work. But yeah, I'm just kind of thinking, like, I'm already using 3 meters, it'd probably just be better, because this uses 4, right? Yeah. But, like, this chain right there, the damage on that? Holy shit! What do you actually do off of that? Can you do, like... oops. Okay, so you can do that, but I don't know how useful that is mid-screen. Just fucking chase him down from here, like, ah! Waste all of the meters. I need to remember how, like, safe this is. And how it basically kind of gives me a little bit of a mix-up all in and of itself. Can I actually do that? Like, if I do Agito all the way up here, kind of. So that might be useful. That's another thing I actually want to test. Oops, that wasn't it. Damn it, that wasn't either. What am I trying to test here? So I think I would want to do... goddamn Lynx! Goddamn Lynx! Does all work. Interesting. Okay. So can I just do like... oops, shit. That does all work. Oops, what am I doing? Too low. Lynx, man. They're so hard. Oops. What am I trying to do right now? I already forgot. What am I trying to do? Lynx. Holy shit, I have so much work to do. Wait, that doesn't work? I thought that worked. I know this does. But that doesn't work, really. I would have sworn on my life that that worked. But it doesn't. Totally worth that 50 meter. I wonder if, like... do you think, maybe because of how Hakumen's meter works, maybe rapid cancel should cost him a bit less? I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. That wasn't what I wanted. Anyway, so obviously, as you can see right now from my Hawkman shit, I have so much work to do. Let me actually check, so let me see. Just off of that, that does 38.79. But if I did... Yeah, that actually does more to cancel it, but granted, it does cost a second meter. And I get, like, 130 extra damage for that. Which isn't really worth it. But if I did... What am I doing? It's such a difficult prospect to deal with this whole meter thing, about knowing exactly how many meters you want to pick and just processing all that information all at once, versus just being able to do like, fuck it, let's just do all of this at once. Damn it. Oops. That'd be perfectly fair. Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, shit. Oh, that doesn't even work, really? That is something. Holy fuck. And that's not even like a real confirm. That's just like a, hey, does this work? Kind of thing. That is a combo. How much that uses? 5, right? Yeah. But I think that's actually probably one of the highest damage starters. But then of course, if they somehow block that, I mean, come on. Who's gonna just block that? Right? Like, there's no reacting to that shit. But they might guess. But if they do react to it, like, that's just... Wait, can you not? Really? You can't back... You can forward cancel that, but you actually can't backdash it. That's incredible. And this uses 4, right? Yeah, so I wouldn't be able to do that. But even like... Oops, not that. I basically get the meter back. And like, that's off of full health too, if I don't, God. I mean, there's absolute, it's unquestionable that if I want to play this character, I need to have overdrive in my game plan. Like, it's not even worth, I mean, this is a character who, like, it's legitimately viable to do this round start. It's just worth it, because you get so much meter at the start of it. And having that meter is huge for Hawkman. I just need to figure out that. I need to figure out mid-screen confirms. Best combo ever. Darn. That's also the best combo ever. Anyway, I've sat here and I've dicked around for long enough. Thank you for watching. I'll have more for you soon. Obviously, I will be posting about opening up lobbies and, you know, come see me, etc., etc. Some point soon. It's just, like I mentioned, it's too late right now to expect anybody to actually respond to those, and there were lobbies available already, so I just popped into it. But I'll be here soon. Thank you for watching. Peace.